What's up guys? Ngayon pag-usapan naman natin ang iba't ibang klase ng graphs at saka paano ba natin i-construct ang mga chart, mga pie graphs at saka mga line graphs. Paano ba natin ito i-construct? Ha? So itong pag-usapan natin ngayon, types of graphs. Okay? So histograms, frequency, polygons and ogives. After organizing the data, they can be presented in graphic form. This is done because it is easier for most people to comprehend the meaning of the data presented graphically than numerically. The three most common graphs are A. Histogram, B. Frequency Polygon, and C. Cumulative Frequency Graph or Ogive. So, ito yung letter A natin, histogram. This is a graph that displays the data by using vertical bars of various heights to represent the frequencies. So ito yung mga vertical bars, ha. This is vertical bars of various heights to represent the frequencies. So to draw a histogram, first mark the classes on the horizontal axis and frequencies on the vertical axis. So ito guys, dito nyo ilagay ang mga class boundaries, ha? At saka dito nyo ilagay sa vertical axis, ito guys, horizontal, ha? Horizontal yung class boundaries, and then yung frequency is dito sa vertical axis. Next, draw a bar for each class so that each height represents the frequency of that class. The bars are drawn adjacent or end-to-end to each other. So, after nyo maglagay ng frequency at saka class boundaries, and then mag-draw na kayo ng vertical bars. Dapat yung mga vertical bars, end-to-end sila, walang gap. But there is a case that kung yung frequency is zero, so meron talagang gap. But kung yung frequency niya is merong at least isa, so dapat walang gap. Magkakaroon lang ng gap kapag zero yung frequency, ha? Okay. Next, frequency polygon. This graph displays the data by using lines that connect point plotted for the frequencies at the midpoint of the classes. To draw a frequency polygon, mark a dot above the midpoint of each class at a height equal to the frequencies of that class. So, yung gagamitin natin dito sa baba, yung horizontal axis, gagamitin natin yung mga class midpoints. And then dito, yung frequency pa din yung gamitin natin. Ha? So, next, mark two more classes, one at each end, and mark their midpoints. So, itapat nyo lang yung mga given frequency. So, lagyan nyo ng dot, lagyan nyo ng dot, lagyan nyo ng dot. So, note that these two classes have zero frequencies. Lastly, join the consecutive dots with straight lines. So, i-connect nyo na after yung malagyan ng mga dots, after yung malagyan ng mga dots, so i-connect nyo na. Ha? So, huwag kayo magsimula dito, ha. Huwag kayo magsimula dito. Dito, yung point is dito magsimula kapag magko-connect na kayo, ha. Dahil ito si 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Ito yung mga midpoint. So, it means kung midpoint sila, meron pang number nakauna dito sa number 2. After sa 2, meron din number dito. After sa 3, meron namang number dito. So, it means ito silang lahat is class midpoints. Ha? Okay? So, ogive. This is a graph that represents the cumulative frequencies of the classes. So, ang gagamitin nyo naman dito guys is yung mga cumulative frequencies. Ha? Yung cumulative frequencies, then dito naman yung mga class boundaries. Okay. To draw an ogive, mark the class boundaries on the horizontal axis and the cumulative frequencies on the vertical axis. Okay? So again guys, dito nyo ilagay ang class boundaries, and then dito yung cumulative frequencies. Okay. Next is plot the cumulative frequencies at each upper class boundary. So dapat yung gamitin nyo dito ng class boundary is yung upper class. Merong dalawa kasi yan guys eh. Merong lower class at saka upper class boundaries. So ang gagamitin nyo dito is yung upper class. Okay? So upper class boundaries are used since the cumulative frequencies represent the number of observation accumulated up to the upper boundary of each class. Okay? So again guys ha, ang gagamitin nyo dito, is upper class boundaries, at saka dito naman is cumulative frequency. So, example 1. Using a frequency distribution below, construct the following. A. A histogram. B. A frequency polygon. And C. An ogive. So, ito yung given table na frequency distribution. So, yung class limits, 1 to 5. So, class width natin dito is 5. 1 to 5 up to 36 to 40. And then, class boundaries is from 0.5. Bakit naging 0.5 ito? Dahil nag-subtract dito tayo sa dito sa lower limit. 1 minus 0.5 is 0.5. And then, bakit naging 5.5 ito? Kasi, nag-add tayo dito ng 0.5. 5 plus 0.5 is 5.5. And then, class midpoints natin. So, saan nakuha ito si 3? Yung midpoint ng 1 to 5 is 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yung 3 is ang class midpoints or class marks. And then, frequency. Meron tayong given na frequency, 11. Ito, given ito lahat guys ha. Given ito lahat guys. And then, yung cumulative frequency. Ito ang cumulative frequency ha. So, paano nakuha ang cumulative frequency? 11, copy. 11 plus 9, 20. 20 plus 6, 26. 26 plus 5, 31. And so on. So, ang total frequency, guys, is 40. Again, guys, given ito lahat, ha? Okay. So, ang first na gagawin natin, guys, is histogram. Okay. So, paano mabagawa ng histogram? So, use class boundaries and frequency. So, itong mga class boundaries, guys, at saka frequency, ito ang gagamitin natin dito. So, yung class boundaries, guys, ilagay natin dito sa horizontal. Ha? Oh, 0.5, 5.5, up to 40.5. So, ito yung guys, 0.5, 5.5, up to 40.5. And then, dito nyo ilagay ang frequency. Ha? Dito nyo ilagay si frequency sa vertical axis. Simulan natin yung paggawa ng histogram. So, first, punta tayo dito, guys, sa table. 0.5, 5.5, yung frequency niya is 11. Ito, 0.5 to 5.5, yung frequency niya is 11. So, dito tayo, ha, 11. Ayan. Next is 5.5, 10.5, frequency niya is 9. Ito, 5.5, 10.5, frequency niya is 9. Dito tayo. Ayan. Next, 10.5 to 15.5, yung frequency niya is 6. So, dito tayo, guys. Ayan. So, next is 15.5 to 20.5, yung frequency niya is 5. Ito yung 5, guys, ha. Dito tayo. I-label natin dito. Ayan. Next is 20.5 to 25.5, yung frequency niya is 6. So, ito 6. Dito tayo, guys. O, ayan, no? 6. Next is 25.5, 30.5 is 0. So, wala tayong frequency dito, guys. So, wala tayong gagawin niya. Wala tayong gawin na bar. Okay? So, dito na, proceed na tayo sa 30.5 to 35.5. So, ito. Dahil yung frequency niya is 2. O, dito. Level niyo sa 2, ha? Level niyo sa 2. Next, 35.5, 40.5 is 1. So, dito. Level niyo dito sa 1. Okay? So, ganun lang ang paggawa ng histogram. Okay? So, next is letter B, frequency polygon. So, use midpoints and frequencies. So, itong mga midpoints na naman, midpoints at saka frequency ang gamitin natin dito para magagawa tayo ng graph. So, dito sa baba, dito nyo ilagay yung mga midpoints. And then, yung frequency, dito nyo ilagay sa vertical axis. So, frequency. Gawa na tayo guys ha, 11, 11, and then midpoint niya is 3, so dito tayo 3, 11, 3, so gawa ka ng dot dito, dot. Next 9 and 8, 9, at saka yung 8, so dito tayo guys, gawa ka ng dot. 6 and 13, 6, 13, yan. Next is 5, 18, 5, 18, dito. Next is 6, 23, 6, 23, 6, dan saka 23 sa baba, 23. So dito. Next is 0, 28. So dito yung ilagay, ha? Dahil walang ang 0 na dito sa baba yung 0. O dito, o dito, ha? Lagay 0. Next is 2, 33, 2, and then 33. Yan. Last is 1, 38, 1, 38. O yan. So next is magawa kayo na i-trace nyo lang, ha, gawa nyo ng line. So since itong si 3, 8, 13, 18, ito yung mga midpoint. So before sa 3, mayroon pang number dito, ha. O, anong prior kay 3? Diba mayroong 1, mayroong 2. O, so dahil itong si 3, 8, 13, mga midpoints lang yan sila. So mayroon pang number prior before sa kanila. So magsimula kayo dito, mag-trace dito. Ayan na, dito kayo magsimula. Huwag kayo magsimula dito sa 3. Itong line guys ba, itong line. Kung mag-connect na kayo ng line, huwag ka magsimula dito sa 3. Ah, dahil mayroon pang number before sa 3. Dahil ito si 3 is midpoint. Oh, so dito ka, connect mo lang, gawa ka ng line, i-connect nyo lang, i-connect, connect, 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 connect. Okay? So that is a frequency polygon. Next, letter C and O give. Use upper class boundaries and cumulative frequency. So ito. So ang gamitin nyo naman is class boundaries at saka cumulative frequency. In the class boundaries guys, yung gamitin nyo lang guys is the upper class boundaries. Ito yung upper class, ha. Ito yung upper, si 5, 10 hanggang 40.5. Ito yung upper class boundaries. Then dito naman, ito naman si 0.5 up to 35.5. Ito yung lower class boundaries. So, yung gamitin nyo is upper class boundaries. Ito yung ilagay nyo dito sa baba. Ha? And then, cumulative frequency ang gamitin nyo. Ha? Dito, dito sa vertical axis. Then, dito sa vertical axis, guys, kung napapansin nyo, 5, 10, 15, 20, kayo na bahala. Ha? Kayo na bahala dito. Pwede kayong maglagay dito ng 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Pwede ding 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, pwede ding 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. Kayo na bahala. Ah, depende na sa inyo. Depende na sa inyo. Okay, now, itapat na natin guys, ha. So, 0.5, 5.5, 11. So, ano siya ang 11? Dito, 11 guys. 11, dito tayo sa 5.5. Okay? So, 5.5. O, ito guys, so dahil ang ginamit natin dito guys is only the class boundaries. The upper class boundaries. So dito tayo, dito natin itapat sa 5.5. So 5.5 at saka 11. Next, 10.5 at saka 20. 10.5, 20. Dito tayo guys, 20. So ito guys, 10.5 at saka 20. Next is 15.5 at saka 26. So, dito makikita si 26. Oh, 25. Next sa 25 is 26. So, dito makita. Then, next is 20.5 and 31. So, 20.5 and then 31. So, dito guys. Okay. Next is 25.5, 37. 25.5 and then 37. So, dito. Lagpas kunti ng 35. So, dito, dito, dito. Okay. Next is 30.5, 30.5, 37. So 30.5, 37 dito. O yan. So same lang sila guys, ha? Same lang dahil 37 yung frequency. Then next is 35.5, 39. So 35.5, 39. So dito before, bago mag 40. So dito, ha? Bago mag 40. Next is 40.5 and 40. So 40 dito. O ayan, ha. So, and then, i-connect nyo na. Oh, i-connect nyo, i-connect. So, dito naman guys, sa OGIB guys, dito kayo magsimula sa 0.5. Ah, dito kayo magsimula. Huwag kayo magsimula dito sa 5.5. Dito kayo magsimula. Ah, before sa class, upper class boundaries. Kung ano yung upper class boundaries, kung ano yung lower class boundaries dito, dito ka magsimula sa lower class. Ah, dito yung first line mo. Okay? Check your progress using frequency distribution table below. Construct the following: A, histogram; B, a frequency polygon; C, an OGIB. So ito yung mga given example na frequency distribution table. Okay? So kayo na bahala, guys. So kung kaya niyo i-comment sa baba, so kayo kamo na bahala, ha? kung kaya niyo i-comment. Okay? So next is the other type of graphs. Pareto graph. It is used to represent a frequency distribution for a categorical or qualitative data, and the frequencies are displayed by the heights of vertical bars. So, dito yung frequency. So, ito yung dito yung ilagay yung mga categorical or qualitative data. So, yung categorical data dito guys is mga places like Manila, Cebu, Cagayan de Oro, Davao, Bacolod. So, ganito ang gawin nyo guys, ha. So, example nga tayo. Example, construct a Pareto graph for the number of health conditions per 100 reported by the elderly in a survey. So, condition and number. So, yung mga elderly, yung mga matatanda na mayroong sakit nga or condition na arthritis, so mayroong 48 person. Then hypertension, mayroong 36 na condition, heart disease 32, cataracts 17, diabetics 11. So gawan natin ito ng Pareto graph. So ito 'yan guys. So ang gawin nyo guys, yung mga condition ilagay nyo dito sa baba. Ilagay nyo dito sa baba, at yung mga frequencies ilagay nyo dito sa vertical line. Okay, so again guys, kayo na bahala dito guys ha, kung anong mga number nyo ilagay nyo. Pwede kayo ng by 2, by 5. Pag sinabi kong by 2 is 2, 4, 6, 18. Pag sinabi kong by 5, 5, 10, 15, 20. O kung gusto niyo by 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, kayo na bahala dito, ha? Okay, now, gawa na tayo ng bar graph. Gawa na tayo ng bar. So, ito, arthritis is 48, di ba? 48 yung arthritis, so. So, dito natin itapat. Dito natin i-level. 45, yung gitna is 48. So, dito natin, ha? Arthritis. Next is hypertension is 36. So, dito natin makikita si 36, hypertension. O, ayan, hypertension. Next is heart disease 32. Heart disease is 32. Dito natin makita. Ayan. Cataract 17. Dito si 17. Dito si 17. So, cataract 17. Then, diabetes 11. Diabetes is 11. Dito si 11. O, ganun lang. Simple lang, guys. Ito lang gawin nyo, guys. Oh. Pareto graph. Ha? So, time series graph. So, it is used to represent data that occur over a specific period of time. So, ito yung example ng time series. Growth of a certain bacterium over an 8-hour period. So, ito yung growth niya. Growth. Ito yung growth na. Makita naman sa line. Dito sa baba, dito nyo ilagay ang time. A number of cells or number of frequency, dito nyo ilagay sa vertical line or vertical axis. Always guys, nga yung mga frequency ilagay nyo dito sa vertical axis. Okay, so example 3, a bacteriologist charted the growth of a certain bacterium over a period of 8 hours. Construct a time series to represent data. So hours, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So number of cells ito. So, ito yung gawin natin, guys. So, ito yung given nga dito, guys, ha. So yung time guys, dito nyo ilagay sa baba, yung time. And the number of cells dito nyo ilagay, ha? So na 1 hour, number of cells 2. Oh, dito yun guys. 1 and the number of cells 2. So dito yun, dito yun guys, ha? 1 2. Next is 2 5 2 5. So dito yun guys, 2 5. Next is 3 8. Dito yan, 3 8. Okay, 3 8. Next is 4 4 13 4 13. Dito yun guys. Next is 5 17 5 17. Dito yun guys, ang 17 makita. Ayan. And next is 6 22 22 6. And next is 7 30 30 7. And lastly is 8 38 8 38. Dito yun guys. And then i-connect ninyo guys, ha? Connect ninyo, connect. Oh, ito. Yan na, connect guys. Oh, simple lang guys, madali lang gawin ang graph. Okay? So, time series for growth of a certain bacterium over a period of 8 hours. So, ito na yan guys, ha. So, makikita nyo, yung graph niya is para kang aakyat ng bundok, ha? So, yung growth niya guys is habang tumatagal yung oras, is lalong tumataas yung number of cells. Ganon. Okay? Next is the pie graph. It is a circle that is divided into sections of wedges according to the percentage of frequencies in each category of the distribution. So, ito yung pie graph, guys. Kita niyo yung pizza, guys. Yung pizza pie. O, parang ganito yun, guys. Bilog, saka slice-slice, ha? Mayroong naka-slice, ha? Naging pie. So, kung nakikita nyo dito, guys, mayroon tayong 58%, 9%, 10%, 23%. So, all in all, kung i-add nyo ito lahat, guys, it is equivalent to 100%. So, it means, itong buong circle, guys, is 100%. So, kayo na bahala, guys, mag-divide, ha? Kayo na bahala mag-divide. So, since 58%, it means malaki yung area niya, ha? Malaki. So, 58, and dito 9%, 10%, 23%. So, ang best gawin nyo dito, guys, i-divide nyo ito by 4. I-cross nyo, mag-cross, cross, ana-ana. Oh, ayan, cross. So, dito, start kayo 0, 25, 50, 75, 100. O, ganun na. Dito ang 0, then 25, dito sa gitna, then dito 50, and then dito naman 75, and dito 100. Or gawa kayo ng by 10, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Mali. 10, 20, 30, or by 5 na lang guys. Cut. Okay? So next tayo. Example. A survey of 500 families were asked the question, where are you planning to spend your vacation this summer? It resulted in the following distribution. Place. So number of people, gusto nila 50 people gusto nila mag-spend ng vacation sa Davao. And then 200 people gusto nila sa Boracay. 125 people gusto nila sa Palawan magbakasyon. 90 sa Tagaytay, 35 sa Baguio. So all in all 500 people. Okay? So first is gawa muna tayo ng percentage. So paano ba gawin? Convert each frequency to percentage, ha? Convert muna natin. So, formula nga guys is percent equals F over N. F means frequency. Yung over N, ito yung N guys, total frequency, times 100. So, dito tayo guys, Davao. Yung Davao guys is 50 yung frequency niya. So, 50, i-divide natin sa 500 dahil yung total N is 500. So, 50 divide 500 times 100 is 10%. Sa Palawan naman, 125. 125 divided by 500 times 100 equals 25%. Sa Baguio, 35 times 500 divided by 500 times 100 equivalent to 7%. And then, Sa Boracay, 200 over 500 times 100 is equivalent to 40%. And then Tagaytay, 90 divided by 500 times 100 equals 18%. So mayroon na tayong nakuha na percentage, guys. All in all, kung i-add nyo ito, guys, 10 plus 25 plus 7 plus 40 plus 18 is equivalent to 100%. Ha? So ito yun, guys, ha, gawa tayo ng pie graph. So ito yung result kanina, guys. Davao 10%, Boracay 40, Palawan 25, Tagaytay 18, Baguio 7. All in all is 100%. So using a protractor, draw the graph and label each section with the name and percentage. So ito, guys. Oh, ito na yan ang result, guys. So first, magawa kayo ng buong circle. Then using the protractor, kung alam niyo yung protractor, guys, ha, para mas madali, gamitan niyo ng protractor. Okay? So sa Davao 10%, ito yun, guys, 10%. So maliit lang yung area, guys, 10%. And then sa Boracay, so mas malaki dahil 40%. And then sa Palawan, medyo, oh, ito yung, guys, so 1/4 ng buong circle is Palawan, 25%. And then Tagaytay, 18%. And then 7% sa Baguio. So ito na yung pie chart natin, guys. Okay, that's end. Bye-bye.